I'm dumb enough to walk in a soaring still. I'm dumb enough to ask for a date with Lauren Hill. Some people only see that I'm white, ignoring skill. Cause I stand out like a green hat with an orange bill. But I don't get pissed, y'all don't even see through the mist. How the fuck can I be white? I don't even exist. I get a clean shave, babe, go to a rave, fry from an overload and dig myself up out of my grave. My middle finger won't go down, how do I wave? And this is how I'm supposed to teach kids how to behave. Hi, my name is
my stepfather said that I sucked in the bed. So one night he snuck in and said, we're going out back. I want my dick sucked in the shed. Can't we just play with Teddy Ruxpin instead? After I fuck you in the butt, get some head, bust a nut, get some rest. The next day my mother said, I don't know what the fuck's up with this kid. The B-Raw, yeah, maniac, that shady dog. Man, that motherfucker's gangsta. Ain't he dog, shady dog. What be going through that fucking brain of yours? Say no more, what the fuck you waiting for? Sing along.
Count the skeletons in my closet, under my bed and up under my faucet. Then you would know I've completely lost it.
Is he nuts? No, he's insane.
Count the skeletons in my closet, under my bed and up under my faucet. Then you would know I've completely lost it.
Is he nuts? No, he's insane.
Don't you know what belch means?
Yeah.
Well then tell me, would you rather get belched or do the belching? Fuck him in the ass, suck the cum out while you're belching. Belching, go back for a second helping. Can you dig what I'm saying, man? Could you smell me? I want you to feel me like my stepfather felt me. Fuck a little puppy, kick the puppy while he's yelping.
Shady, what the fuck you saying?
I don't know, help me. What the fuck's happening? I think I'm fucking melting.
Marshall, I just love you, boy. I care about your well-being.
No, Dad, I said no. I don't need no helping. I'm a big boy. I can UA by myself. See, I only get naked when the babysitter tells me. She showed me a movie like Nightmare on Elm Street, but it was X and they called it pubic hair on Chelsea.
Well, this is called ass rape, and we're shooting the jail scene.
Baby, don't feel my pain, just smile back. And when I'm gone, just carry on, don't moan. Rejoice every time you hear the sound of my voice. Just know that I'm looking down on you, smiling. And I didn't feel a thing. So baby, don't feel my pain, just smile back.
60,000 people all jumping out their seat. The curtain closes, they're throwing roses at my feet. I take a bow and thank you all for coming out. They're screaming so loud, I take one last look at the crowd. I glance down, I don't believe what I'm seeing. Daddy, it's me. Help, mommy, your wrists are bleeding. But baby, we're in Sweden. How did you get to Sweden? I followed you, daddy. You told me that you weren't leaving. You lied to me, dad. And now you made mommy sad. And I bought you this coin. It says number one dad. That's all I wanted. I just wanna give you this coin. I get the point. Fine, me and mommy are going. But baby, wait. It's too late, dad. You made the choice. Now go out there and show them that you love them more than us. That's what they want. They want you, Marshall. They keep screaming your name. It's no wonder you can't go to sleep. Just take another pill. Yeah, I bet you you will. You rap about it. Yeah, word, can't keep it real. I hear applause. All this time I couldn't see. How could it be that the curtain is closing on me? I turn around, find a gun on the ground, cock it, put it to my brain, scream die shady and pop it. The sky darkens, my light flashes. The plane that I was supposed to be on crashes and burns to ashes. That's when I wake up, alarm clock's ringing. There's birds singing, it's ringing. Haley's outside swinging. I walk right up to Kim and kiss her, tell her I miss her. Haley just smiles and winks at her little sister, almost as if to say,
when I'm gone, just carry on.
This is kind of interesting. We found this, I think, on eBay. This is an album of baby lullabies, lullaby versions of your songs. And, for instance,
is that me?
That's, I guess, baby you. Somebody put this out. Stan is on here, which seems like a strange song to play for an infant. Kill You is on here. Is it? Do we have a little of that? Let's listen to just hear what it sounds like.
No, actually, you know, when I was going through a rough time with, you know, drugs and things like that, and when I decided I wanted to get clean, I reached out to him because I knew that, you know, he had went through a similar thing. So it was like, okay, you know, from one addict to another, I need some advice. You know what I mean? Because Elton's been clean for 20 some years.
And that's the guy you think of calling is Elton John?
Well, yeah, because, you know, he's a celebrity and he's been through it. You know what I mean? So it was like, and he gave me some pretty good advice.
You know, I'm an advocate of hip hop. I love hip hop. As far as it being entertainment, I understand that it's entertainment. But he said something that strikes a point. You have to be able to separate it. But unfortunately, for Slim Shady,
you're talking about Eminem.
Eminem, Slim Shady, yeah. Marshall Mathers. Unfortunately, he's doing things in the public eye as far as pistol whipping people and things of that sort. So now people are saying, hey, you really are doing what you say you're going to do. So you can't really separate the words.
There's no irony.
There's no irony anymore. And especially he's going to court this Friday to supposedly be sentenced. And this is my view on this. If he doesn't do any time, I don't think he should do a long period of time because he has a daughter. But if the court doesn't make him an example, because he has a lot of young kids' minds, and if they let him walk, they're saying, hey, it's all right to walk around and pistol whip people and pull guns, you know, and he's America's golden boy. Now, if he'd have been a black kid that was doing this, unfortunately, he'd be in jail.
Oh, I don't know. Puffy and others have gotten
well,
rid of
no.
all kinds
I'm not going to say
stuff.
That. I'm not going to say that. I mean, well, I'm not going to talk about Puffy. We're talking about Slim Shady
okay.
right now.
Let me read one of the quotes from the book. A miserable, drug-addicted young man, a mere paper gangster manipulated by his manager and handlers who keep him high and intoxicated. Is that fair? Is that a fair description?
That's fair and it's true.
Yeah?
It's very true.
From the book, a miserable, drug-addicted young man, a mere paper gangster manipulated by his manager and handlers who keep him high and intoxicated. Is that fair? Is that a fair description?
That's fair and it's true.
Yeah?
It's very true.
Yeah. And you find all that out in my book.
Yeah, the book, Shady Business, was out in the book. But what was your own personal experience? Why'd you split up with him?
A couple of reasons. The first reason, I wasn't being paid what I was supposed to be getting. Anybody that's a bodyguard and you're out on the road and you're doing more than bodyguard work, you should get at least $2,000 a week. I was only being paid, starting out, $1,200 a week, which I agreed to. But as my job started to grow into like being the babysitter, the chauffeur, the part-time accountant, I wanted more money. And I presented them with several proposals to, hey, say, look, I won't write a book or anything like that. I'll do you guys exclusive security. They didn't want to do any contract. And then it started becoming more things where he was getting out of himself, out of character, started becoming more work for me. And I said, you know, I've had enough. I'm out. And then when I resigned, they canceled $6,000 worth of checks last December.
Should we feel at all that the book is a payback?
You know what? I'm going to be honest with you. When I first started writing the book, it was to be vengeful. But I said, no, my father and my mom said, if you're going to write the book, be fair. You know, tell 50-50, good and bad. And basically what I decided to do in my book, Shady Business, is let people know how he is as a person, how people manipulated him, how he manipulate people, how the industry is.
Is let people know how he is as a person, how people manipulated him, how he manipulate people, how the industry is.
About managers and...
Do you like the guy?
I like him as an artist. At one point in time, I can honestly say, you know, I consider him as a little brother. I cared about him. You know, even today, I look at him as if he's going to blow it with some of the bad decisions that he's made. And that has happened because I'm not with him. I had his ear. I made him think about everything he did before he did it.
And let me ask you, Alex.
Cats in a rage with today's youth and bodily. Crush the glass with my bare hands and swallow it. And spit it back in the faces of two racists and hypocrites who think the same thing but don't say. You Liberace, Versace, and you watch me cause you thinking you got me in this hot seat. You wanna judge me cause you're not me. You'll never stop me, I'm top speed as you pop me. I came to save these new generations of babies for parents who failed to raise them cause they're lazy. To grow to praise me and make go crazy. That's how I got this whole nation to embrace me. And you fugazi if you think I'ma admit wrong. I cripple any hypocritic critic I'm sicked on. And this song is for any kid who gets picked on. A sick song to retaliate.